Hello, this is Echo and Clock, welcoming you to, Undertale. I'm not sure exactly what I'm supposed to be doing here. Alright, I have failed. Ooh, I'm so sorry. Looks like you're out of time. Here come the flames, darling. They're closing in. Getting closer? Oh my. Any minute now. Robotic cough. Watch out. I'll save you. I'm hacking into the firewall right now. Oh no. How could this happen? Fooled again by the brilliant Dr. Alphys. That's right. Come on, Metaton. Give up already. You'll never be able to defeat us. Not as long as we work together. Your puzzle's over. Now go home and leave us alone. Puzzle? Over? Alphys, darling. What are you talking about? Did you forget about the green tiles do? They make a sound. Then you have to fight a monster. Well, darling, that monster is me. Still, his metal body still renders him vulnerable to attack. This is it, darling. Say goodbye. Is that your phone? Better answer it. Hey, this seems bad. Don't worry. There's one last thing I saw to your phone. You see that yellow button? Go to this phone's act menu and press it. Press the yellow button. Phone is resonating with Metadon's present. Oh, that yellow glow. Now press X. Fantastic. Oh, you defeated me. How could this be? You were stronger than I thought, etc. Looks like you beat him. You did really good out there. All thanks to you. What? Oh no, I mean, you're the one doing everything cool. I had specific programs for your phone. Hey, this might sound strange, but can I tell you something? Before I met you, I didn't really like myself very much. For a long time, I felt like a total screw-up. Like I couldn't do anything without ending up letting everyone down. But guiding you has made me feel a lot better about myself. So, thanks for letting me help you. Anyway, we're almost to the core. It just passed MTT Resort. Come on, let's finish this. What's this way? Hey, it's Flames Hotsman. Hey, do you remember my name? Yes. What? You remember? How could I be so easily defeated? I'll always remember that you remembered. Okay. Oh, okay. At least I know where I am. He seems happy. Oh, hey, we're taking a rain check on that killing you thing? Like, don't tell Undan about this, okay? Hey, it's you again. Business is excellent here. These two fellas put all my ice cream. I've actually sold out of everything. Sorry, wait, so I get something for you. Big smile, how about that? I'll buy it. Hey, go up the crew alley for the right for some great deals. Oh, hey. Hey, heard you're going to the core. How about grabbing some dinner with me first? Sure. Great. Thanks for treating me. Over here. I know a shortcut. Well, here we are. So, your journey's almost over, huh? You must really want to go home. Hey, I know the feeling, but although, maybe sometimes it's better to take what's given to you. down here, you've already got food, drink, friends. Is what you have to do really worth it? Ah, forget it. I'm rooting for you, kid. Hey, let me tell you a story. So I'm a sentry in Snowden Forest, right? I sit out there and watch for humans. It's kind of boring. Fortunately, deep in that forest, there's this huge locked door, and it's perfect for practicing knock-knock jokes. So one day, I'm knocking on out, like usual. I knock at the door and say knock-knock, and suddenly, from the other side, I hear a woman's voice. Who is there? So I respond, dishes. Dishes who? Dishes a very bad joke. Then she just howls with laughter, like it's the best joke she's heard in 100 years. So I keep them coming, and she keeps laughing. She's the best audience I've ever had. Then, after a dozen of them, she knocks and says, knock knock. I say, who's there? Old lady. Old lady who? Oh, I did not know you could yodel. Wow. Needless to say, this woman was extremely good. We kept telling each other jokes for hours. Eventually, I had to leave. Pyrus gets kind of cranky without his bedtime story. But she told me to come by again, so I did. Then I did again, and again. It's a thing now. Telling bad jokes through the door. It rules. One day, though, I know she wasn't laughing very much. I asked her what was up, but she told me something strange. If a human ever comes through this door, could you please, please promise me something? Watch over them and protect them? Will you not? No, I hate making promises. And this woman, I don't even know her name, but someone who sincerely likes bad jokes, has the integrity you can't say no to. Excuse me. Do you get what I'm saying? Oh, just took a bad sip of water. That promise I made to her. You know what would happen if she hadn't said anything, buddy? You'd be dead where you stand. Hey, lighten up, bucko. I'm just joking with you. Besides, haven't I done a great job protecting you? I mean, look at yourself. You haven't died a single time. Hey, what's that look supposed to mean? Am I wrong? Heh. Well, that's all. Take care of yourself, kid. So, because someone really cares about you. Where'd he go? Some kind of TV show feeding him at a ton. As I came in, I realized I forgot to make a reservation. But I didn't want to look like I messed up, so I kept walking in anyway. Now I'm just kind of consuming dew off this ficus. Originally, we dug mazes with puzzles in order to foil human attacks. But now, building things winding and fusing. It's some awful tradition. Can't go, 2 feet without being up to your armpits in puzzles. I work at the core. The inside is a maze made up of swappable parts. That means we can shuffle the layout at will. Boy, was today a fun day. Sure love puzzles. I'm the resort comedian. I'm very funny. Please laugh at my jokes. Now, my son, he wants to compete. He wants to be a comedian like his father, but his jokes aren't funny. He tells these awful puns. He's an embarrassment to our family. Ha 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 ha. That's not funny. Since his mother passed on, he couldn't stand living at home anymore. So he ran away. I haven't seen him since. I'm a terrible father. Ha 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 ha. That's not funny. I'm sorry. I appreciate his jokes. Blub blub. You'll have to reserve a table to eat here. You also need to reserve your chair, your serverware, your food, your... Alright. relaxing atmosphere of this hotel, it fills you with determination. Hello, welcome to MTT Resort, Holland's biggest apartment building turned hotel. Whether you're here for a night or still live here, MTT Resort prides itself on a great stay. Just passing through? Nice. MTT Resort prides itself on being passed through. Alright. I want to check out this. Hey, check it out. Yeah, check it out. But I can't afford any of your stuff, really. I want the mystery key. So, like, what's up? How about you two? I'm Braddy, and this is my best friend, Caddy. I'm Caddy, and this is my best friend, Braddy. The stuff inside is, like, totally wicked expensive. But, like, the stuff we found is, like, totally wicked cheap. You should, like, totally wicked buy all of it. I mean, like, where does anyone get guns or food or... We found it in the garbage. It's good garbage. It's, like, really good garbage. Where do you get the garbage? Like... the garbage store, duh. Waterfall, mostly. I found a gun in a dumpster. Oh my god, Metaton. He's like my robot's husband. Actually, he's like my robot husband. I think we're like both going to marry him. We're like both already married to him. He just like doesn't know it yet. So like, Dr. Offie's been Metaton, right? That's, like, what they tell you. But, like, Metaton's always acts like being built was his idea somehow. Even right after he was built, he acted like Alfie was an old friend. But they're, like, not friends anymore. Yeah, unlike me and Braddy, best friends forever. Oh my god, Alfie's. She used to live on our street. She was like a big sister. I mean, like, your big sister takes you on trips to the dump. She showed us the coolest places to find trash. She was always collecting these weird cartoons. Then she became a royal scientist. Yeah, we haven't seen her forever. So Alpheus was always like, thought Asgore was a super cutie. So, like, I'm pretty sure she made Metaton to, like, totally impress him. A robot with a soul. That's, like, super relevant to his hobbies. So after seeing Metaton, Asgore asked her to do all the science stuff for him. But nobody's, like, seen anything from her yet. Or her at all. She must, like, just stay in her lab all day. Like, live a little girl. Yeah, like us. Oh my god. He's a total goober. He's a big, fuzzy goofball. Like, I love that guy. He's, like, so nice. God, we're, like, so hyped for the destruction of humanity. Alright. Thanks, but we, like, don't really need anything. Oh my god, can you go get some clam burgers? We don't really need anything. Wait, I'll pay you 1,000 G if you get Metaton and autograph my butt. Alright. Like, see you later. Like, later and stuff. I was actually thinking about, like, in the editing process, like, overlaying all the parts of that, but I decided not to. Ooh, room service. Got my CT. Then? Ooh, room service. Got my cinnamon bun? No, you don't. Do I have a cinnamon bun in my cell? No. You hear shuffling. Seems like you could put something under the door. You didn't have anything appealing. Seems busy. Hmm. The elevator is in use. This elevator goes straight to the Capitol, but it stops working. The hotel doing its best to accommodate everyone stuck here. Yeah, I'm not gonna be home tonight. I think there's some cold pizza in the treasure hoard you could heat up. As a slime, I'm outraged. Alright, I think with that, I will see you next time. This is Beckman Clock. Goodbye.